DJL here in the house. That's a little shout out to my boy Jess Josh. How you doing out there, guys? Yeah. So hey, I ordered. There was a deal today. It was $176.50 on Amazon. Now I know we just covered this on MTG Roundtable, and you know if it's possible, if it's not, you know we'll see what's up. But yeah, we're gonna see if this is a legitimate deal that everyone and their mother is getting scammed, getting repacked, or if they are getting legitimate stuff and claiming it. So we're gonna see if it happens to me, guys. So I'm trying this out. Hopefully I don't get ripped off and I get some pretty sweet pulls. But as you can see, it's right there. It's from Amazon. I haven't opened it yet. Let me see if I can get a little bit of air. Oh, that was awesome. Got a little technical difficulties, but at least it wasn't like full screen. All right. And I did get a new mat, guys. Move this. It's really dark. But I'm going to show you guys real quick. Actually, with the light, it shows up pretty good. I don't know. This is obviously probably, yeah, I don't. Not MTG, but it does look pretty cool. But yeah, there you go. My Verdict Catacombs. Oh, yeah, baby. This was supposed to be a whole board, but they screwed up. So I know I got to take the cellophane off, but I'm like, I don't know if I want this mouse pad. Because it's supposed to be big like this. Then that would have been badass. But new. So a little bit of a mail there too. All right. So there it is. We're going to get to that in just a moment. Good, Chris. There's been a string of videos lately claiming that there has been. So hopefully that's not the case. If it is and it's a recent thing, then it will suck. But I have proof. You guys are all watching me crack this live. If it's bogus or not. And we're going to have a real quick look at that as well. Before we get to that, though, guys, obviously go visit my sponsor, NorthValleyGames.com. Use this code at checkout, DJL808. Get yourself 10% off. If you guys are selling cards, an additional 10% to the buy list price. Also, if you guys show me proof that you bought something from them and you use my code, I'm going to hook up 5 bonus entries. There you go. Obviously, like, comment, and subscribe if you guys are watching this later. I'm really curious. I hope I don't get scammed. If I do, we're going to see it right now. So let's get to it. So I just want to prove it is an address. That's my real name, but I just don't want to show my address. Most of you guys have it anyways, so it's not like it's a big deal. But you can see it's sealed. It's all Amazon, baby. Let me get up in here. And we're going to see if this is legit. Okay. See, I didn't do any cuts or anything weird. Okay. Let's have a look. There's none in the front, but it's all in the back. I don't know. That looks a little suspicious up there. You guys seeing it? Yeah. I mean, the back looks legit, so I can't really tell there, but there is weird stretching here, and this up here looks totally, it could have been resealed with that soldering iron, and you can see it goes all the way around, and right here it seems a little suspicious there. But other than that, the feel looks, and it feels normal. Tape shut, yeah. So far, so good. But before I crack it and hope that it's legit, I'm going to go ahead and crack this bad boy right here. Oh. Oh, boy. That one was messy. Already blemishing the new mat. Okay. Well, I don't know. What do you think, Tornado? Looks like it's been slid down the box. Okay. Well, I don't see any tape or anything. That's I don't know. It just seems a little tight, you know? It's not loose. It just got condensation all over it. All right, hold on. Just wiping off the monster, got a little too excited. Okay, it looks, I don't know, it looks legit. I mean, ish. So let's open up the pack and see if it's been messed with on the inside. It is a little tight, though. I'll give it that. Okay. All right, let's see. Box toppers. Box toppers. All right. It seems legit. It seems legit. They feel like they're in there. I don't see any weird pressings or anything strange. Okay. Let's see if those packs. No weird slit. Okay. So far, so good. And they're not cut on the back. I don't know. Seem pretty legit. Seems pretty legit. Okay. Let's open some. And yeah, I think we're good. Okay. I need you guys to pick a... Well, there's not too many people in here, so let's do a D6. I just happened to find this little signature card. I'm going to throw it in one of you guys' boxes. So pick a number between 1 and 6. Oh, sure. Yeah, I hear you, Tornado. All right. Chris has got 4. Oh, hi, Kaishin Himura. How you doing, bud? If you could, you got to pick a different number between than 4 because Chris got that. But hey, do me a favor and smash that subscribe button. And of course, if you guys wouldn't mind, that like button as well. We're going to get crack these bad boys real quick. Awesome, brother. So if you could pick a different number, Tornado, pick a number between 1 and 6, bud. If you guys are just stepping in and our current subscribers, awesome. Pick a number between 1 and 6. If you are new and hasn't subscribed, obviously subscribe. We're doing some sick giveaways at 500. So thank you, Ken Shen. Appreciate it, bud. All right. So let's do this bad boy. Let me find a die. Okay. All right. Screw it. We'll do D6. So Torpedo, I need a number from you. 1 to 20. I'm just leaving his 7 alone because I don't want to re-explain. I'm reading your comment, Tornado. Yeah. Never had any cut open. No, they were resealed is what I was talking about, those videos. So I'll show you guys real quick. While you're picking your number, Torpedo, I'm going to... You'll go 3? Okay, cool. We got 4 and 3. Just need you to pick one, Torpedo. Torpedo, someone already got 4. That's everyone's number today is 4. That's crazy. That is crazy. All right, so we got... I know there's a delay, too, guys, so don't trip. But, yeah, Torpedo... Screw it. I'm just going to roll out. And if I hit that 4, I'll do odds evens for Torpedo and Chris. So I want to get this knocked out real quick, and then we're going to crack some packs. All right, here we go. That is a 4. No wonder you guys were all choosing 4. All right, so Chris and Torpedo. So Chris, you're odd, and Torpedo, you are even. All right, Chris Walker, you got it, bud. and I've simplified. And for you guys that are new to the channel and are wondering what's going on, I do some random giveaways when I go live. It's not every time I'm live, but, you know. And instead of mail it all out and waste all my money not getting boxes, I basically fill up. You're going to get your own little plastic card holder thingamajig. And I'm just looking for Chris Walker. So I have it here. Let's see, is it in this one? KC, sorry. No, not that one. Okay. Similarly, I do the same for international, but like once every other month, I try to get a big package out internationally, which costs money. So, but normally when I ship, I spend money on it because like I want to make sure you guys get it with the tracking. There's Chris Walker. Okay. So it runs up a pretty bill, but anyway, all right, cool. Chris Walker's in the house. Boom. Let's crack some packs. Yeah. All right. Yeah. No, Chris, you got it. There'll be more, but, all right. So I don't feel any special glue. This is cracking pretty normal. And there's the streak line that you always get. Looks like my, let me figure this out real quick. Get out of my way. Okay. We'll just set those aside. It's like, we have a bright climb pack boy, but foily boy, pretty nice. All right. We're going to get through these real quick. Got a mountain, Grackmaw, Ravenger, another pathway, Jank, World Shaper, and a Fearless Fledgling. That is a crappy pack. Pathways are nice, though. That full art pathway looks sick. Yeah, all right. Got a Mesa Lynx. Got a Swamp. Hey, Raging Crabs. All right. All right, first Mythic, Seagate Stormcaller, and a regular Blightclimb pathway. Okay. Blah, 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 blah. Hey, double mythic pack. We got Scourge of the Skyclaves, all foily boy, an illusion, and an insect. Joke. So two mythics so far in one pack. All right. You know what we want to see. I see something shiny back there, but I'm not sure if that is what I think it is. All right. Coveted prize. Thief. Ruined Crab. Skyclave. All right. Got Nahara. Hair of the Ancients. I'm going to be giving that away here in a minute. Boom. We got Shadow's Verdict. Mar, mar, mar. Bogus pack. But we did get a mythic. Okay. Got a Plains. Magmatic Channeler. Okay. Soul Shatter. Ah, no expeditions yet. But we got a Skyclave Shade. And all right. Mythic number 4. Turn Timber Symbiosis. All right. So left side is definitely pumping out some mythics. I'll give it that. But that's not what we're after. Okay. We got a Forest. Awesome. Conundrum. Oprah. Needle Verge Pathway. Oh, my girl. Yeah, yeah. Actually, I did want more of these foils, so I am stoked on this. I got to use her. I wasn't too impressed, but that's freaking sick. Nice. I'm stoked on that. I am stoked on that. Okay. Thanks, Tornino. I will. I'll check the next pack. These seem pretty normal. I mean, I don't know why they... No big mythics yet, but it doesn't seem like it's been tampered with. It's just my luck isn't that great. Okay. Scoot Swarm. Hey! All right. First... See, these would be gone. You wouldn't even get these. But here is our first expedition. I don't I'm not sure if I had that foil or not, but I'll take it. It's my colors. I need the fetch, but hey, you know. All right, first expedition. And now we are on the right side. Okay. Got an insect. Ah, Valakut in the back there, awakening. That means no expedition. All right. Got a swamp. Hey, cool. Turn timber symbiosis. Another mythic boy. Nectar pot. Jerboa. The lame mammoth. And the acomb. All righty. Let's see some more live. Get some more energy up. I mean, I prefer to have that drink in my mouth and not all over. Oh, dang it. Sorry, I got some condensation. There we go. Okay. Ooh, that might be an expo in back. I don't know. You kind of see the weird thing, so hopefully that's good news. All right, we got an island. Swarm Shambler. Archpriest. Arkham Knight. Just kidding. Dark Worm, Branch Cloth, Prowling Faladar. Hopefully that wasn't a tease. It was a tease. Damn it. Okay. Exploration. Burr, burr, burr. All right. Come on. Be nice to get a 3-expedition box and not a 3-expedition box. But we'll see. We'll see. Got to stay positive, just like Paz says. Okay. Got a Plains. Shadow's Verdict. Manny Canopy, Baloth Ox, Lotus Cobra, might throw that in the mix there, Archon of Amira. Meh. There's 3 packs left, but I want to see some spice, because I'm just like, the hell, bruh. All right, here we go. Be in my colors, bam! Oh, nice. Cavern of Souls, baby. All right. I will take it. I will definitely take it. That is a very nice box topper. It's funny because sometimes I get negative reinforcement. I know it's all about being positive and super like, yeah. But honestly, I was talking smack and look, it gave me a cavern. Oh, call me a repack, will you? Whoa, 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 whoa. Calm down. Calm down. Okay. I have the weirdest problems with inanimate objects, you know? All right. Inscription. Terraju. All right. Got a River Glide pathway and cards wanting to go all over the place. Yuck. Well, that sucked. All right. 2 more packs. All right. Whew. Getting nervous, guys. All right. We got a mountain. We got the worst mythic ever. Hey, you called it, Tornado. It wasn't full extendo, but it's still mythic just the same. Back-to-back mythic. We had Bacon and Homeboy. Skyclave. Ruin Crab, Retreat, and another freaking pathway. Wow. At least it's full art, so that's cool. Oh, last pack magic, baby. Make sure you guys stick around. We're going to be doing 2 different drawings, one for a sick-ass Lotus Cobra and a Nahiri, Heir to the Ancients, full art. Last pack. Oh, man. Oh, I feel it in my bones. All right. So far we're 4 because we have 1 more box topper. But let's see if we can make it 5. Okay. Got a Swamp. We got the Intimidator. Got a Phylath. Prowling Faladar. Another Clearwater. Okay. Spikak and... Oh, baby. All right. All right. Not the foil I'm looking for, but at least it's a fetch. Very nice. We got a Marsh Flats. Let me sleeve that bad boy up. All right. This is up for trades towards the Wooded Foothills. So if you guys have one and need white, black, let me know. Because that's what I'm after is Jund. And let's see what this last one is. Ooh. I'm feeling nervous. Bam. Okay. Okay. I can't complain. I didn't, Tornado. They felt fine. I mean, if they're going to repack, it's going to be lane cards. They're not going to include these bad boys. But it is... Where'd it go? Okay. It's a four. I thought I pulled another one. There's the gorge. Yep, we have the cavern, marsh, and this. So four expedition box. Not bad. Got one fetch, one of the lower end fetches, but it is still cool. Prismatic Vista, Cavern, and a Copper Line Gorge, which I think I have already, but I don't know if I have it foil. So I'm not overly disappointed. Now, if I can move this Cavern of Souls, then I could probably get, because I'll probably have to buy a Wooded Foothills. No one's selling right now. And if they are, it's like buku. Kenshin, I'm looking for any at this moment of the Wooded Foothills. Just any. I'll even take Tarkir. I don't care. I just I need one. I actually need two for two decks. So two commander decks. All right. The Mythic Call was just kind of okay. This is cool, definitely. That's whatever. That's also cool. This I'm stoked on just because. And also to get a foil version of that. The Scourge, that's dope. I don't play blue, so I'm not too stoked on that. But yeah. Oh, yeah. Kenshin, are you here in the States or are you international? Oh, so you don't have any for trade, man. Don't tease me, bro. I need it. One for Windgrace, and then excuse me. Oh, Rhode Island, sweet. Okay, bet. But I needed it for this guy. So, yeah, kind of bummed. But all right, I'm gonna clean up. Right now, we're gonna be doing a drawing. We got to start a box for you, Kenshin. All right. I'm going to sleeve those bad boys up here in a minute. But, all right. So here we go. Let me go ahead and just sleeve these up. I'm going to shuffle these. The person that wins the roll-off will get one of these cards. So we got a Dud, we got a Lotus Cobra, and an Ahiri. So, I don't know which one you're going to get, but we're going to do a roll-off right now. Let me get these up so I can shuffle them and not scratch them up. And we're going to see who gets what. Okay. So, going to shuffle on screen. Off screen. Hey, Kevin, how you doing? You just missed it. All right. Here we go. Back on screen. All righty. And homie needs the white one, so we'll see if you get it. Okay, D20 time. Number between 1 and 20, guys. Go. Yeah, just okay, Kevin. Oh, hello, Will. I don't recall if you subscriber or not, but if you aren't, smash that subscribe button and like. I appreciate it, bud. If you are, I just missed you. I guess it's first live stream. Okay, we have a lot of sevens. All right, so we got Chris Walker at 17, Ken Shin with 15, Will Wilson with 7. He popped up for me first, Kevin. So if you want to pick a different number, oh, you did. Perfect. 9. All right, is that everybody? I see 5 in here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, okay, Will. I know I run them pretty late, but during the summer, it's kind of a necessity because it gets it to be like about $1.20 in my room during the day. It probably not, but it feels like it, and I can't work in that. Can't do nothing. You know what I mean? All right, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that it, guys? Oh, Torpedo. I don't know if you're still here. Torpedo, are you still here, bud? If you guys are just popping in, we are doing a random drawing right now. If you are subscribed, you can win. If you're not, go ahead and subscribe so you can win. And I need you guys to pick a number between 1 and 20, not the ones that are chosen currently. So, no Torpedo still hanging out. Yeah, I think we're just missing Torpedo. Unless anyone else popped in, go ahead and pop a number in real quick. Give it a couple more seconds. There we go. All right, let's roll out. I got a mess here. I was thinking Cavern of Souls before I started because I just sold one. I mean, now I got a fancy version, but I really need the wood foothills. All right. Here we go. I got a different die. Okay. Here we go. I'll do a stop. 3. All right. Who got 3? Is it Will? I think it's Will. Will's the closest. All right. Well, I need to make you up a box anyways. So cool. Let me grab you a box. And I know my sorting method is like ridiculous. Okay. Happened to my dang pen. All right, there we go. And Will, do me a silly favor. Can you pick a number between? Well, do not pick. Don't pick number 8, but a number between 1 and 22. Okay, I'm just writing this up. Oh, wow, Tornado, really? Wow. Okay. Okay, so you picked 21. I'm going to do that real quick, and then we'll see what you ended up with. But I need to finish this. Will Wilson. Okay. All right. Before we pick, let's see what we got. 21. I think I just made this one. Oh, yeah. You guys seen this the last few streams.
Morty, go ahead and activate this golem.
Agana Aksaka Sapulu!
All right, who wants to be infused with, like, unreasonable power?
Oh, can I be, like, a sexy arrow shooty lady?
Yeah, whatever, there's no rules, I don't care. Morty, you want superpowers?
No thanks, I'm fine, I've got my book.
All right, good luck with that. Let's go.
All right. Okay, so I'll shuffle again, or I'll leave it alone. Wow. All right, Tornado. That's weird. Probably something with your YouTube or something. I don't know. All right, Will. Here we go. Let's see which one you got. Bam. Uh-oh. Chris is mad. He wanted this one. All right. I missed that call. I'll go and shuffle. Screw it. Let's see if you end up with it again. Oh, okay. Lotus Cobra. All right. First one for your box, Will. That's pretty sick. Hell yeah. Yeah. It's, I know there's a 15 second delay I can't do anything about, guys. And it's the same between, like me seeing your messages. So sometimes I'm talking, boom, you respond to me, and then I see it 15 seconds later. So it's like a good like 45 second delay for me seeing your comment. So it's just the way it is. All right. We got two left, guys. All right. So we'll go ahead and chill on this one because I'm going to do a different game in a minute. But I'm going to go ahead and leave it up to you guys again. Whoever, all except Will. And don't worry, I'm going to have some other games coming up. Okay. So, number between 1 and 20, guys, and I'll roll out for it. Especially Chris, Kenshin, and Will, you're chilling on this one. Chris Walker, Tornado. Oh, the white one or the Lotus, definitely. Definitely run it in Windgrace as well. Okay, here we go. We got Chris Walker, Kenshin with 12, Kevin with 4. Anybody else? Okay. All right, I'm gonna roll it. If I see a number pop in right now, I'll take it. Oh, we got a battle between Chris and Kevin Hain. Okay. So between Chris and Chris, you'll be odd, and Kevin, you'll be even. Oh boy. I'm sorry, Chris. All right, Kevin got it. Let's see what you got. And I think Chris will trade you for the white card if you get it. So here we go. White card? Oh, no. Okay. There you go, bud. You got a full art Nahiri hair of the ancients. Pretty sweet. It's not foil, but still pretty cool. All right. Kevin, I got to find your bucks. Not sure if I'm pretty sure I haven't mailed out to you quite yet, Kevin, but I'm not sure. Oh, sweet. Nice. I actually pulled the full art foil Nissa in this box, which I've always wanted to pull one, and I did. So I was like, all right, cool, bet. I did not get the fetches I was after, but at least I end up with one. There you are, Kevin. been a minute. Okay. You're getting pretty close, bud. Just need a little bit more and you're in. Cool. Just a couple more. Just need to win a couple of Commander Pipers, and I think I should be getting it off to you finally. Well, you're present, so I'll just leave that there. Yeah, actually, I had one I had to trade for on that, but right now I'm like, I have a hard on for freaking Wooded Foothills because, like, again, I showed you the pre-con, and I have a Windgrace deck that's actually doing really good even without it, but it would be nice to have that land base. As it is, Chris, I think this is you, bud. I don't think anyone really wants that. There you go. I think I made everyone happy. Pretty much. All right. So I think I'm going to crack and work on this one. I wanted to get the Wooded Foothills, or I was hoping to pull it tonight. I would have cracked the other one, but I'm going to see what's in this bad boy here. Yeah, it did work out. That's pretty sick. So here we go. We got the Planner Portal. This seemed fun. I'm going to mess with it and try to pull off three different win cons, but I don't. It might not work out, and I'll just probably scrap it and just go for treasures. But this one looked pretty sick. All right. I keep on thinking that it was a 5, but it's a 4. All right. But anyway. And this one, I actually had a deal with Amazon. It messed up on something, so they gave me some credit. And so basically, I got $30 off those two precons. Oh, wow. So, yeah, here's a useless card right here. They gave you these little tokens, I guess, to keep track of maybe your commander points or something. I don't know. I just like them because they're shiny. But it is cool because they are using a little bit less. And then this thing is just, I don't know, maybe you could set your commander on top of it. Wait, what does it say here? You may use these punch outs as counters or as victory confetti. Nice. All right. At least I got a sense of humor still. Okay. And for some reason, I like this card. There we go. Yay, recycle. Oh, yeah. Well, this one is the, yeah, the red-green one is pretty sick. I'm going to be building on that, but, all right, so this is, this is kind of cool. They actually shrunk down the amount of waste. So I'll give them credit for that. So instead, you get this little poofy thingy. You get a, you know, dial up, dial down, starting at 40. Here's the pamphlet instead of it being all huge. All right, so this explains the deck a little bit. Tells you about the Eye Tyrant, the Warlock Collector, and that dude. On the other side, probably gives you some tips and stuff. Primary Commander Prosper. Okay. Jank. Sorry, I want to sleeve these bad boys. It's making me nervous. I don't want them falling on the ground and getting all scratched up. Remember when that used to be worth a little bit? But this set's been open so much for those expos, you know? Bear with me, just leaving. But so stoked to pull my girl. And I actually have her in Windgrace. I mean, I did put in a big 7-7, but I don't know. It just seems like she should be doing more or something, you know? It's nice on the landfall trigger that you get to load her up with the Planeswalker points or whatever. But it just wasn't, I don't know. The wow factor was like, oh, that's cool. But just, I don't know. She just kind of draws fire from away from Windgrace because people are like, oh, hell no, not on that. You know, whatever. All right, so let's see what we get in here. I know there's a list out there, but maybe you guys can give me some points on what to cut. We might have another episode on this particular one because I'm going to be working on this deck to get it playable. I'm sure it's playable now, but you know what I mean. Okay, so they give you... Okay. All right, maybe not. I'm just going to sleeve these bad boys. Oh, yeah, you see a lot of videos, Kevin? Sorry, I was busy cracking, so let me scroll up and see what I missed, guys. Okay. Oh, yeah. No, I hear you, Chris. You collect sets. I got you. Yep. And Tornado, for Raging Omneth. Yeah, dude. I know. I'm tempted to go over to that one after I mess around with Windgrace a little bit more. The Oversized Kenshin. Yeah, that was a while back. Some people complained about it. I think it's kind of cool, but I have no place to safely store a huge size, you know? Okay. So if you guys are familiar with this deck, beginning of your end step, you're going to exile, and then whenever exile top card of your deck, and then whenever you play a card from exile, you're going to create a treasure token. So this one, just going to go crazy on treasure. That's the main focus, and that's the original build. But, you know, probably Wild Riches or something. I might have the card around here somewhere, but it's just been crazy. All right. I am not familiar. I did read this guy, but I didn't know what he does. Okay. Whenever you attack a player, tap target creature that player controls and goad it. So you can have it basically attack. Okay. Yeah. So they attack each combat if able and attacks a player other than you if able, which I think is cool. Whenever an opponent attacks another of your opponents, you and the attacking player each draw a card and lose one life. Yeah, all right. Here's the Warlock class. Cool. Chaos Chandlers. You find some whatever. Bucknard's Purse. His coin purse. Haha. Okay, so you guys are going to see a lot. Okay, so... Let me backtrack a little bit. So you got to choose one here, right? But you're going to see a lot of like roll D20. Well, with these commander sets, you're going to have to buy other dice because you're going to have to roll a D4 and create a number of treasure tokens equal to the result. That player to your right gains control of Bucknard's Everfull Purse. So this one is political. So kind of cool. I don't know. I'm going to put that in the maybe pile. We have an Ebony Fly. So now you have to roll a D6 on this one. You may have Ebony Fly become an XX insect artifact creature with flying, where X is the result. So if you roll a D6, he's a 6-6. But, you know, whenever attacks another target creature or another target attacking creature gains flying till the end of the turn. Okay. It's kind of cool. Put it in the maybe file. All right, we got one of our lands. Add one, or you can exile it, roll a d20, put target artifact, creature, or planeswalker into its owner's library just beneath the top X cards of that library, where X is the result. Activate only a sorcery. That just seems complicated. All right, let me get caught up with comments here. Oh, you're trying to get Tundra. Wow. Yeah. Good luck, man. Hell yeah. If you don't know, the thick card's actually an authentic card. It's just a different core, obviously. Okay, cool. Well, thanks for hanging out with me, Kenshin. I know when there's something to do. Cool. Oh, right. I wish Omnath, yeah, for sure, man. But there's no mix with black. Oh, yeah, because you have that weird coloration. It might be a misprint. Could make some money, bro. Make sure it's legit, yeah? Okay. Yeah. Let's see. You have a pretty sweet deck. I can send you the list, for example, of Omnath. It's over 1K, though. Yeah, I hear you, bro. Yeah, exactly. On these new ones, man, you're going to need a bunch of dice. All right. Light up the stage. Loyal Apprentice. Okay. That one's your regular lieutenant. Shiny. You got the Chaos Chica's Vandal Blast. Bitumous Blast with Cascade. It's interesting. We got the Charm. Cool. Terminate. Cool. I was wondering about that card. All right, we got Commander Spear, Arcane Signet, obviously. All right, Farewell Stone. I might keep that. Mind Stone, I'm not sure. Relic, no. Got a Signet. Soul Ring, baby. Talisman of Indulgence. That's pretty cool. Unstable. Bazooka Bug, Commander Tower. That's kind of cool. Got the Rakdos, of course. Bag of Devouring. Here's a new one. So whenever you sacrifice another non-token artifact or creature, you have to exile it. Okay. Pay 2, sacrifice another artifact, creature, or artifact to draw a card. Okay. And pay 3, you can sack the bag, roll a d10, return up to X cards from among cards exile a bag of devouring to their owner's hands, where X is the result. Oh, that's pretty interesting. Got a Dance Macabre. Okay, so D20. Whenever a player sacrifices a non-token creature, roll D20. Add the toughness of the creature you sacrifice this way. Okay. It says you. Says what each player sacrificed. Oh, okay. So everyone does that. And okay, got it. 1 through 4, return a creature card put into the graveyard this way to the battlefield under your control. That's pretty sick. Or return up to 2 creature cards put into the graveyard this way on the battlefield under control. So you get 1 or 2 creatures for that. Seems kind of expensive. Death Tyrant. Nice. Interesting. Grim Hireling. It's kind of cool. I don't know if I want to sack all the treasures, but, you know. Oh, this is sick, though. Okay. Whenever 1 or more creatures you control deal combat damage to a player, so this is just a one-time deal, create 2 treasures. So that's pretty dope. Oh, is it? Oh, I didn't know that was... I just saw the card recently, so I didn't think that it was anything. Okay, cool. It's a little value. Nice. Hellish Rebuke. Totally determines opponents. Oh, that's kind of cool. Make him pay for hitting you. That's dope. Here we go. Here's the Lorcan Warlock Collector. It's a devil. Whenever creature card is put into the opponent's graveyard. Okay. Okay, so you could pay life to take whatever you just killed. Yeah, so if something of theirs died, you could pay life and snag it. That's pretty dope. And exile it when it dies. Fiendlash. Oh, that's cool. It's a little doubler. So it already gets +2, and then double the power if it hits a target player or a planeswalker. I'm not sure. That's in the maybe pile. Here's another one. Got to roll a d12. Not a d6, not a d4, or a d20. No, freaking d12. All right. You have to have two of them, two d12s, and then choose one result. Deals damage equal to that result to each creature. Then create a number of treasure tokens equal to the other result. That's dope. Expensive, but that's kind of cool. All right. Share the spoils. Revel in riches is what I was talking about. So whenever this enters the battlefield or an opponent loses the game, exile a top card of each player's library. During each player's turn, that player may play a land or cast a spell from among the cards exiled with Share the Spoils, and they may spend mana as though it were any color. Okay. And when they do, they exile the top card of the library. Very political. I'm going to start skipping through a little bit. So a little cascade for 4. First spell you cast from exile each turn. So if you have a way of exiling stuff, like your commander per se. All right, fever, suspicion. Boy, I guess you can ramp with a little treasure. Okay. Hurl through hell. Like the exile till the end of turn, we cast that card. That's dope. Cheering Witch. And now I'm just going to kind of thumb through. So a lot of these, like I know, for some reason they put rat mix in here. It doesn't make any sense. So definitely cards I'm going to be cutting. Sacrifice creature you gain equal to toughness. Okay, that's cool. And you can rebound it. Nice. Dead Man Stress. Yep. Fiend of the Shadows. We got Gonti. And Hex. I like this card, but if there's not 6 creatures, you can't do it. So, but still pretty cool. Fabricate. Okay. Interesting. Org Slumlord. Yeah, this is definitely not. That's the rat thing. Piper. Yeah. Pontiff. Whenever you cast a spell, you may pay. Okay. Other creatures you control have extort. Okay. So you have to pay to, if they lose a life, you can gain one. Got it. Here's an expensive card. Apex of Power. Vapors is good. Oh, Consuming Vapors. Got it. Yeah, that seems pretty legit. If a scale was cast from your hand, see. That's cool. So you pay frick 10, and then if you cast a spell from your hand, you get 10 back. But you can also play around with whatever is exiled. I don't know. I mean, you're going to use treasures as your ramp pretty much, so. This is interesting and could be Chaos Warp. Yeah, I'm not sure on that. Commune with Lava. Okay. Dark Dweller Oracle. Cool. There's the Dire Fleet Daredevil. So a lot of cast things, kind of playing off the exile a little bit. Go to all creatures you don't control. Okay. Dream Pillager. There we go. There's a Drago. All right, Kevin. Thanks for thanks for hanging out, bro. Appreciate it. Got a Tali. Tali's super fun. Ignite the Future. A lot of exile the top. So that's really playing off of that. All right, we got an Izzet Chemister. Okay. Tectonic Giant. Love Me Bedevil. Oh yeah. Theater of Horrors, Chaos Wand. Meh. Exotic Orchard. Okay. There were some lands in here that I was pretty cool to see. Let's see. As it enters, you may reveal a swamp or mountain from the hand. If you don't, it comes in tapped. So this is pretty much a black and red Snarl. So that's cool. Shadow Bridge for filtering. Smoldering Marsh. I actually have a bunch of these now. Spine Rock Knoll. Who's got the hideaway, so that's interesting. When you play the exiled card without paying its mana cost, if an opponent was dealt 7 or more damage this turn. That's pretty interesting. So a conditional dual land. We got the Void. Not sure on that. And of course, Swamps. Some kind of cool ones, actually. But I like competitive a little bit, so I'm only going to stick with one. It's interesting. And that's cool. They all have a whole story here. That's dope. So this is all like as if you're playing D&D. That's pretty cool. Huge stories. Nice. Okay. So this is the thick card that Torpedo was talking about earlier. See, look at that. That is one card. And this is a very faded Prosper Tomebound. All right, so you got your rats, which have zombies on the other side. You got some servos with treasure. Really? It's a treasure deck, and they only give you two treasures? Okay. Thopter, and okay. So five treasures total when you should be making a ton more than that. Okay. And then just kind of a basic how your turn goes. All right, pretty interesting stuff. Oh hell yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna be messing with this. Revel in Riches is one of my first auto includes, but depending on how much room I make, I might do another stream talking it out with life totals, but pretty much gonna be ditching a lot and then throwing in. I want to see if I can get Liliana's contract off, too. That'd be kind of cool. Because I'm going to have a ton of treasure tokens, so I can definitely get six different demons out. Because you can't have the same name demon anyways. So, you know, maybe if I include like 10 or 15 different demons might help. Revel in Riches for sure for this one. I also need to find Dockside Distortionist. I thought I found a deal. It was Walmart, so I knew it was BS. I went into the store. They said they had it stocked for $41.99. And guess what? They were scratching their head. Oh, I don't know that this is not. I'm like, oh, come on, guys. I didn't even want to go to that Walmart, but whatever. I also saw some deal online, but I think the guy finally pulled it and updated it. To be able to get the deck, it's like $60 to $65, maybe all the way up to $70. For that M19 commander deck, and there's not much else in it, so it's kind of, I don't know. I mean, Dockside Distortion is like $51-$52, so I mean, I could just get the single, but if I can get it for 40, I'm gonna jump on that. But if not, I don't know. Oh, Just Guys Will, yeah, that's a good call. Yeah, I'll just see if I have that. I'm pretty sure I do. What's that? Was that Kenshin? clean up a little bit here. Oh, Commander Legends. Okay. I'll have to see if I pulled it. I'm pretty sure I did. Because it sounds familiar. Whoa. I just love that card. And I have some ideas for dragons, just to throw them in. Oddly enough, the green dragon that just came out, Gnawbone, would be perfect for this deck. But guess what? It's green, so it doesn't go with the color scheme. So, kind of a bummer. Yeah, so I'm gonna tinker with it a little bit and get some sleeves for this deck and see where it will take me. So I'll probably do a stream later in the week, possibly. But if you guys are around, always check it out on Thursday nights. We go live 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. It's called MTG Roundtable. We discuss pretty much all the new stuff for Magic, some beginner stuff, and just all the MTG stuff. So come by. It runs about an hour, 2 hours, and it's tons of fun. So hopefully we'll see you guys there on Thursday. Also, I got to put up the Discord link, but we just got some new merch. You can see the link down below, and it does help support the channel, but we got these bad boys right here, made by Karen of Aartopia. You can get one of these bad boys. Show proof that you guys got one. Send me your receipt or she'll let me know. And then you guys get 5 bonus entries for buying some merch. It's pretty cool. Oh, she's running about 13, 14 for the will. Okay. And let me get some Discord links for you guys. Some of you are in there. It's picking up. It's just been a little bit slow. Oh, yeah, Tornado was right about that edge. Looks so weird. Huh. Okay. Yeah, and the Discord, Joe's talking about sort of Feast of Famine that he got. It just seemed a little weird. So he did the light test and everything. Okay, so let me get you a link, guys. And I'm going to get on the stream here and post that for you guys. Stuff and things. I have to access it because I can't do it on my computer. All right, so that is not it. You try this again. All right. Sorry, guys. I'm just trying to get this link to work. Okay. There's a Discord link. And then I have links for the Facebook if you guys want to get on them there. But let me see if I could pull it up real quick. Of course, we got Patreon and all that fun stuff. Okay. That's weird. All right, that one I can get here. All right. Just going to get the Facebook leak, and then we're going to do another giveaway if you guys are still posted. I guess my boy's Get to the Rares is doing a thing right now. Okay. Come on. So I'm going to do another giveaway, guys, and then we're going to go on to probably get going. So let me post this Facebook link right here. Boom. 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 If you guys want to join the Facebook, should be an auto include on that. So you guys should be able to get right in. All right. Cool. Sweet. Appreciate it, Kenshin. Okay. Let me clean up this little commander pile here. I'm going to go through it a little bit later and see what's up, see what I'm going to keep. I know I'm going to add a lot of Ixalan stuff for the treasures for sure. Throw that jank in there. Oh, yeah, baby. Okay. Blackwood jars with ramp to treasure. Okay. All the checkout. So some dwarves spawn some treasures too. Okay, cool. I'll check that. Magma suite with treasures too. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to start messing with this soon. I got a lot of cleanup and a video to edit tonight. So I'm going to use all that monster energy to get some stuff done. Oh, which one? Oh, is it Magna? Okay. Yeah, that's right. And he spawns the dragons. So, and he's just red. So that works. Yeah, definitely Magna. I have some dragon ideas to throw in too. And maybe that mine, I think it just spawns a 1/1 dwarf, but that'd be fun. All right, who's still kicking it? I know Ken Shen's here. If you guys are just tuning in, we cracked a... Prosper or the planetoral portal or something. I don't know. Yeah, we cracked this. We also cracked a ZNR collectors. We did okay. Did pretty good, actually. We ended up with cavern, a marsh flats, copper, and Presmic Vista. So that was pretty good. It was all legit. All right, Chris, cool. And Kenshin. I'm showing two, so it's just you guys. All right. So this is one. This is two. It's nothing too, like, oh my God, crazy. But let's see. Ken, you'll be odds, and Chris, you'll be even. So here we go. Whoever wins this roll-off gets to pick which stack they want. All right, so it is odds. Kenshin, it's up to you. Oh, nice. I was thinking of making that deck, but I don't know where my castle went off to. The red castle. I know I have it, but it's just like, bruh. Left. Okay, here we go. A maddening kebab, blah, blah, blah. And a inscription of insight. Okay. Let's see what Chris got. Hey, there's an archpriest for you and raging crabs. Just for the meme. All right. Hey, but Chris, you got some bacon tonight. And oh yeah, Kenshin, this is your first time. You haven't I was like, I thought I made a box for you, but you didn't win yet. All right. I thought I wrote one out for you. Did I not? I'm tripping. No, so we got Will. That's right. All right, so the way it works, Kenshin, is once you fill the box, I mail it out to you. It's pretty simple. Helps me save on shipping, too, so I can get more boxes and more prizes. Well, giveaway stuff, you know what I mean? Okay, so Kenshin Mira. You're a big Samurai X fan. Okay, cool. My buddy Life Tolls will probably know a little bit more about that than I would. But Samurai X sounds dope. Okay. So what I need you to do is find me a clip of Big Samurai X that relates to you, Kenshin, and I'll add it as a video button. So next time I see you, I'll totally bust it. So just email me here. Also, your contact info. Like, if you win a bunch, that way I don't have to track you down when I'm ready to mail. So that would be pretty cool. DJ Longridge at gmail.com. There you go, bud. So yeah, should be an email with your contact info. I mean, like, your address, so when I'm ready to ship stuff, I don't have to track you down. That'd be awesome. Because eventually when this gets filled up, so you got a bit to go. But when this gets full up, I mail it. Chris, you're getting pretty close. Probably have to mail you out pretty soon, bud. All right. What am I doing? These are like all the ones I don't want. Let's see if we... Yeah, Chris, you're like super close. You got a package from before though, right, Chris? Or you haven't yet? I'm having a hard time remembering. I mean, I sent out six today, but... those were purchases. You guys were kind enough to hang out with me tonight. I'm going to give you both a round of Piper. So this is Commander Piper. The way it works, Kenshin, is you draw a card. You're going to get whatever that commander is. If it's a Prismatic Piper, this is called Piper Commander, or no, Commander Piper. Anyway, if it's a Piper, instead of getting one rare off the top here, you're going to get three. So I'm going to fill up a lot from what I bought today in this, but I'm going to go and shovel this bad boy up. And I'm going to get you and Chris a round. Okay, dope. Okay, Chris. All right, so let's go and get Kenshin going. Get his box filled a little bit. And then, yeah, boom. All right, little Lena, selfless champion. Okay. And rare. Oh, look at that. Both from M19. That's crazy. A little Valiant Knight. I guess pushing you towards going white. And let me... And then, of course, three jank foils. You'll see I give away a lot of white and blue because I play Jun colors. But also, I need to cull my stuff a little bit because I have a few rare boxes I haven't gone through yet for extra black and green and red. Okay. So there we go. You see a guard approach. Secret door and a commanding presence with the guy with the evil smoking eyes. Yeah, I don't know. If I saw some guy attacking me with smoking eyes or that were like on fire, I'd just be like, you go, bro. I'm just going to like walk over here. Leave me alone. All right, Kenshin. So we got a little bit of a little bit more for your box there, bud. All right, Chris, let's see what you get. This might get you there. I don't know. You still got a little bit of wiggle room. Okay, shuffle this up. Boom. All right, we got Thrax, the Sudden Storm. Okay. Boom. And a Serpent of Yawning Depths. Pretty cool if you're trying to throw bombs in your blue deck. But if you also, it'd be fun to see this. A Kraken, Leviathan, Octopus, and Serpent deck. That would be fun. That way they can't be blocked. Just for funsies. All right. Okay, a little Lens Flare action. Corridor Monitor and a Dawn Evangel. Now, I do have Mythics mixed in here and some decent value ones, but just let you know, I never know what's going to be because I just throw some random stuff in there sometimes. Okay, cool. So, guys, thank you all for joining me today. And, which one? Oh, Kenshin, you play Jun too? Yeah, I hear you. Yeah, I just finished Windgrace. It's working pretty well. And I don't have the Wooded Foothills I need for that deck. I know I need a second, at least one more. Obviously, a playset would be amazing, but not at the current prices. I can't wait till they do the friendly or alliance fetches. That way that it will come down a little bit. But those are all now skyrocketing because we had the enemy fetches in MH2. So it's just like, I really don't want to pay $40 or 40 for cons, but it's like 50 plus for like Expedition or any of the other ones. So it's like, I need that card bad. I also need Bloodstained Mire, but the Bloodstained Mire, I have one copy of cons, but you know, it'd be nice to get some more so I don't have to keep pillaging from other decks. That's the goal anyways. All right, guys. Well, later on this week, I'll probably have another live stream working out the kinks in this deck that we just cracked, the Prosper deck. I will probably crack Dragonborn later in the next day or two. I'll probably crack that. But yeah, thanks for hanging, guys, and I will catch you next time. Bye. Oh, all right, Kenshin. Yeah, let me know, man. I don't have much the way it trades, but we'll work something out. Cool, brother. Definitely need help with that, so I won't say no. All right, guys. You guys have a great one.